The channel. Just want to do a quick video on the loader operation on my Kioti CK3510. It's tough to really get a visual on how the thing's going to operate based on stats that you can get off the internet or a sales pitch you're getting from a salesman. So when I was out buying this, I did a ton of research on these tractors with, you know, lift capacity was a big one. Hydraulic flow was another big one, but they didn't really have a ton of videos on, you know, actually watching it work. So I want to just give you guys a good example of the operation of this tractor and show you how fast the loader goes up and down and the tilt function. And I did a recording of both inside the tractor, kind of first person. I also did a recording of outside the tractor to give you an idea of both. So if you check it out at around 4 minutes and 15 seconds, you'll be able to see from the outside. But please like and subscribe. Hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching.
But yeah, see, this is the skid steer bucket I talked about in the previous. I don't know what it came off of or what type of skid steer, but it's quite a bit bigger than the one that came on it. And it makes a couple, probably half as many scoops to fill this trailer. So, but again, it's still not big enough to really make you teeter at all. To actually keep up with what's going in every week, I bet you we fill a dump trailer a week. And like I said, we range from, I don't know, I want to say we've got about 15 horses typically. So once a week we could fill my dump trailer, which fits about 12 yards, I'd say 10 to 12 yards depending on, if it's a lot of hay and straw, or if it's all sawdust, definitely 10 to 12, it can vary a little bit. So it's quite a bit of manure. And we got quite a pile here. I think we probably got a couple hundred yards over here that I'm trying to keep up with. It's all about where I'm keeping it. So I'd love to just take a load or two every week, but the place we take it to doesn't always have either room for it, or it's a little too muddy and I worry about getting stuck. So I'm gonna try it today, hoping that everything's frozen. I'm sure it is. I don't think they got as much snow as we got, but I don't really think it'll matter. It's only 6 inches or so at this point, but it can create a slippery situation, but it should be okay.
drive up. Ugh. Where's your shoe at? Oh, I hope I didn't lose it. I remember walking outside without a shoe on. Got both your things here. Alright, well, we'll come back, pull back around the house, gotta drop the kid off, and then we'll tarp it. See you in a bit.